my cultists, my name is Matthias and welcome to a new episode of the Temple of Dolls. This doll is part of a collab, but I had this doll planned months before I was invited to join it. The collab is a Christmas collab, but the doll isn't. I will talk about that in a second. This doll is based on my second favorite holiday. I don't think I can call it a holiday per se, but it is easier for me to call it that, so I will call it a holiday. The holiday I'm talking about is Lucia, which is celebrated throughout Europe, but I will stay focused on the Swedish tradition. It's small, cozy, and you aren't really forced to be with people or really take part in it if you don't want to. The holiday is named from the saint with the same name, but I will talk about her a little bit later. Lucia takes place on the 13th of December. The main celebration is to watch a Lucia Tåg, or a Lucia train, which is a train of people coming and singing Lucia and a Christmas song. If you go to school, you will probably watch a Lucia train at some point during the day, or be a part of it. I've been a part of many Lucia trains during my life. Though different schools have different rules about who is organizing or taking part in the train, some have that a specific class is doing it or that people who want to sign up do the thing. And if you are a parent, you probably go to at least one Lucia performance. There is also a tradition to enjoy a Swedish fika while listening to a choir. There are a few characters who appear in the train. A Lucia, Tenor, and Skärgossar. Santas can also appear in Lucia trains. I myself have been mostly Santas. The Lucia is, of course, the main character in the train. She goes first in line and will be always standing in the middle. Lucia Linne, or Lucia Dress, is always a must-have for all the characters, except Santa, which is a white, non-form dress. The Lucia does also sport a red satin ribbon tied around her waist, and the most recognizable thing, a crown made of light. For children, we have plastic ones that you can get from any stores, but the real Lucia light crown is made of living lights. Next is Tenor, which stands next to Lucia and goes behind her in the train. They sport the same white dress but doesn't have a crown or a red band. They usually have glitter tied in their hair and waist instead. Instead of crown, they carry a single candle in their hands. The last one worth mentioning is Skärgossar, which is traditionally the men slash boys. They sport the same dress. They usually don't have anything tied around their waist, but I know that I've seen them sometimes having the same glitter as Tenor. They have their Skärgossar hat though, which is just a white cone hat with golden stars. They also have their paper star wands, which is just a golden paper star on a stick. Now I ramble on for almost a full page about the tradition, but I wanted to give context to the doll and share some things about the holiday. But now we will be getting to the doll. I will not go with doing the Lucia we see in Lucia trains. I want to go more with some sort of spirit, a ghost who visits the cold winter forest during December 13th, lighting up the path while she walks with a warm light. I also want the crown of light to be a part of her head. I'm going to use Spectra. What other base will you use for a ghost spirit? I also want her to be mostly white with a few spots of red. After I cut off her hair and pop off the head, I use pliers to scrape out the glue on the inside. But since I'm going to sculpt the crown on her later, I can cut the back of her head to help me with pulling out all of the glue hair. This was such a pleasure to do. So easy. After that is done, I take 100% acetone to wipe off the factory face and the collar of her scalp. Don't forget to clean the head with warm water and soap. The dress will be pretty simple. It will just be a white dress. Though I do want to go with the traditional dress design and instead we do more of a Renaissance dress. Because DJ Requiem has this Renaissance pattern that I have wanted to buy for a while now. This dress was easy to sew, but those sleeves were a nightmare to turn inside out. But they are so pretty, I can forgive it. The same step as normal, cut out the pieces, glue the borders of the fabric so the fabric won't fray, glue the hem and then sew everything together. I will sew Lucia into her dress so it won't be removable, but I will do this later. But super glue the head together and after that is dried you can pop the head on and take her outside to spray her with 2 layers of anesthesia. So I said I was going to talk about the Saint of Lucia, since I do find her story fascinating and it also gives some context to some of my design choices. But you can't really talk about Lucia without talking about the saint that the holidays are based on. Lucia of Syracuse, or Santa Lucia, was born at Syracuse, Sicily, 283 AD. She was the daughter of a Greek mother named Eusicia and a Roman father, who doesn't seem to have any name apparently. She was born into a wealthy elite. Her father died when she was 5, so she was raised by her mother. She was Christian. During a time that Christians were persecuted, the Roman Emperor Diocletianus was during the time giving laws that Christian books should be burned, churches should be burned down, and Christian leaders should be executed. Lucia is actually one of the Catholic Church's most prominent female saints. Even as a child, she gave a promise of chastity and hoped that she would be able to give all of her worldly possessions to the poor. While growing up, her mother tried time and time again to give her hand away to a young man who wasn't Christian. Lucia was able to hinder the marriage and usually prayed to God to save her from it. The young man got angry that she didn't want to marry him and in turn he went to the emperor and outed her as a Christian. According to legend, she was sentenced to serve a brothel, but when they tried to move her to a brothel, they weren't able to move her an inch, not even with 1,000 men and several oxes. She was then sentenced to burn at the stake, but the flames were not able to burn her body even if she was smeared in oil, resin and pitch. After the failure of the burning, she was beheaded. She ended up with the martyr's death, and that is what the red satin belt symbolizes. Saint Lucia is the guardian of the blind and she's often depicted with holding a dish with 2 eyes. There is a story behind this. A young man had fallen in love with the saint's beautiful eyes. She ended up tearing them out and sent them on a dish to the young man as a gift. In turn, he baptized himself and she was rewarded by God with getting a pair of new, even more beautiful eyes. There are some more stories about the saint, but I want to cover the basic. She died around 303 AD, so she got only around 20 years old, which would be more sad if it wasn't for that she lived around 300 AD. I don't think that many people lived past 30 back then. Now is the time to make the light crown that I have been excited to work on ever since I came up with the concept. I wanted the light crown to be a part of her head, making her more ghost-like. Epoxy would have been the easy stuff to use here, but I will actually use polymer clay for this project since I want to use translucent clay. I think the crown ended up looking much better because of this than if I had just used epoxy sculpt and painted it white. I used a spare spectra head and wrapped it in tinfoil to protect the head. I glued some extra tinfoils to make the shape of the candles. I want the candles to be hollow since I will be putting light in them later. The translucent clay was really nice to work with. No matter how much I work with it, there would be not a single fingerprint on it. There would be dirt, but at least the fingerprint wouldn't show up. After I was done with the sculpting, I put the whole head in the freezer for a few hours. I think like 2 to 3 hours. This hardened the clay enough for me to pull it out from the head and with that, I will be able to bake the clay. This translucent clay was really nice. I was prepared for it to mooning, but it didn't at all. I had prepared myself for it to moon, but it didn't, so I was a little bit shocked when it didn't do that. After the baking, I had to take out all of the tin foil, which was easier said than done. I was successful in the end, but it probably took me like a full hour to get all of it out. I've used this string light that I got from the dollar store. It would have been better if I had done my own lights, a la Delightful Style. But I wouldn't cross-think you to work with electronics. You might end up burning in the house down. So dollar store light it is. I used hot glue to stick the lights in place. This took a while since I had to make sure that the glue had dried before going to the next light. I was able to get it relatively flat, which we'll have when we put it back on the head. Before I glued the crown down, I had to put the battery pack down the dress so it would be able to be hidden. I also have to coil the rest of the light around the body, which don't look that nice, but it's hidden under the dress so no one will notice. The crown doesn't fit exactly to the head. I think even if I did my best to keep it flat, there is still some bulge. Also, I think it might have shrunk a little bit in the oven. But that's what hot glue is for. The nice thing with hot glue is that it mimics running steam pretty well. So I take it and fill up the space and also add some details to the crown. The light glows through the dress. And I wanted to see if I could cover them with something that would make them not as bright. First I thought I could use white acrylic to cover them. Then I thought, I am stupid, I can't cover them with white. I have to cover them with black. So I did that. This worked out better, but not good. I ended up covering all of the lights with Dutch tape, and this helped in dimming them. There's still a small light, but it's faint, so it don't bother me as much. And after that, she's done.
Natten går tunga fjäll, rundgård och stupa, kring jord som sofälet, skuggorna ruva, då i